Hey there guys, today will be my flower tutorial, so we just jump right into it here. I'm going to start by cleaning off the front end of my blank, making sure that there's nothing on it, no trash or scratches. So I just see one little spot back here on the side I'm going to go ahead and get. Okay, I'm just going to finish my gather. was I just had a little chunk of trash up here towards the back end, and I wanted to go ahead and grab it while it was hot now. I didn't want to have to skin the whole thing all the way up there on the back when I first started off, so I just cut it off the left to it and grabbed it off. I'm gonna put the heat kind of on the front half. I don't want to heat too much towards the back. That'll help you keep it in line when it needs squish. As you're pushing down, it's going to try to get out of center from you, and you're just going to push it in the direction that it tries to go off center as you're spinning. I'm going to go ahead and hit the back of it real quick. In the front. At this point, I'll go ahead and pull a little center point. So just help me determine where I'm going to place my pedals. Actually, let me see if I can find my glove real quick. If I have one in here. And this one will have to do. Just go as close to center as you can. This is going to help determine where you're going to draw your pedals. Always clean up your tips before you start the next pedal. Go ahead and do the next one. I'm sorry, I'm going to go ahead and squish these in really quick. Then I'll do the next one. And so whenever you melt these back too, you're going to let me pull the tips off of these as well. Getting ahead of myself here. Now whenever you are melting in your first set, you want to be careful of the tips. They're going to try to melt first because they're sticking out the furthest. And so you want to heat up your whole piece and not just that color. I'm going to focus the heat on the Maria and not the color. Right on the tip of that Maria, right in the middle. The entire time that you're working it, you're going to concentrate on the color, making sure not to hit it too hard with the flame. You want it, like I say, the front piece to heat up evenly. You don't want that color to go too hot. You don't want to overwork it. That's what will cause a lot of your bubbles. Sometimes colors can just be more difficult than others. You can encase colors in more fire-friendly colors, flame-friendly colors. This will help you apply more heat without it boiling on you. Sink this in a little bit. So once again, come to the back, let the whole piece warm up, not just that color. Peg mine to the ends that you just cleaned off. You want to kind of marva them down into place. The middle of that Maria, you want to keep the heat off the face and off the color, and let just the heat-based game. Try to go too fast, and you rush the color, it'll boil on you. Patience, patience with these flowers. Especially working with some of the cadmiums and stuff. Must go really slow. Sometimes if you're working with turbo cobalt or something like that, you can go a little bit faster. It all depends on what color you're working with. Okay, so I'm just going to get that in there a little bit. Trying to keep it off the face as much as possible and just on the Maria. A lot of you guys and girls out there, you all have a torch with a little bit wider center fire. You all can focus it a little bit more. You're going to try to put it right. If it was a car tire, you'd want to put it on the outside edge of the tread. Get it hot and you're going to get that clear to start sinking over the color. Get it to concave, that color will go inside a little bit. And after it does, put it over, you compress it, and it pushes it inside a little more. Back, let everything level out, let everything get back on axis. Put it a squish. Go right back into melting it in. If you deviate from that, you're going to lose a lot of your heat base, so it'll take a lot longer. I know a lot of times sitting there doing a demo for somebody or trying to explain, it can take even a bit longer because you're having to explain, you get sidetracked. So you let it go in a little bit, you let it sink in, come back. Start to finish a few rotations. Press. Keep your heat base, go right back into heating it up. Back, let it all level out, there. Alright, this is about the point I like to add another set of pedals. For the sake of this demo, this will be the last set. I really do like this less is more. Do find beauty and simple. Simple designs. Very beautiful. Okay, so I'm just going to come in. This time I'm going to, I've got my first two layers, I'm going to come in, I'm actually going to make a petal shape. I'm going to bloom it outwards a bit. So we get the effect of blooming. I'm just pulling off the ends that are raised up. And then whenever I start to heat it back up, I'm going to start it back here. You'll notice those ends light up first. I'm going to take a breather. So you'll notice those ends light up first. And you're going to marble them in a little bit, and that's just going to keep them from overheating. You know, help it all heat up at one time. Sometimes you don't even have to do that, it just depends on what colors you're working with. So, keep the heat on the Maria and off the color. Let the whole piece heat up. After it is sunk in a little bit, I will take my knife and we'll carve it. I use a brass knife. actually handmade. That's nice. I really like my old handmade tools. Really nice little impression too. I'm just going to come in and I'm going to put a carve right into the center of each petal. That is going to be our last layer of our cherry, and our next layer will be with that new timber. Nice and cool out today. I was actually up all night as well. So you know what? It is very cool out today. Today would be a perfect day for this. So here I am, making a flower model with you guys. So you go from heating the hip of that Maria to kind of heating the outside tread. Keep the heat focus there, but still kind of off that color. And it's going to get hot once she's able to move a little bit. And go back to elbow up, get it to move, get it to concave. So it's hot enough now. Back up. Right on that outside thread. Go back. Give it a squish. you have to pause the video, go back and watch this stuff, feel free to do that. It takes a long time to learn all of these steps. So I'm going to condense and compress one more time, and then we will add a layer of beads. I'm just going to go right in between where I drew my petals. Just the Maria, try to avoid the color. up together. Again, that's raised inside. I'm going to go ahead and carve it. Just right in the center of each leaf. Focus it right on that front edge, but not the color. And you're going to start getting it to move. Go back. today. Don't be afraid, it'll get a little bit messy. You're going to clean all of this off on the end whenever you terminate it. And so right now the object is just to drag those petals and the leaves towards the center, starting with the leaves. So I start with the leaves, I grab it, and I pull it. Heat it up, grab it, pull it. jump out in the center. You want to be careful not to spin it. So a good way going about that is just not to spin as you pull off. Just keep working this termination and get it as clean as you can. After you're satisfied, you will add your stem. Center. pick, and I'm just going to poke it just to hair. Show you how to do that in just a few. You picked up something, I'll have to clean it up. Never stop and I never hesitate to stop and clean off anything that might get on it. Pressing it so hard, I'm going to let it go a little bit more. Be gentle with my presses. referring to earlier, that stem is getting up inside there, and I'm just going to reach on in there and grab it. So you're just going to make it as dry as you can before you pop it off. That's a better option so you know it did not get plenty. It's another good time to mention that having this little bit of thick neck, this little bit of extra neck on it, allows you to build up your marble and make it round. And it will allow you to keep control over it so it doesn't flop around. this, I'm just going to pop off the end of this here. It's got some trash on it. To avoid getting anything on this, I'm going to clean it off. Helps when you start with clean. Cut it off, look for any scratches or scuzzes that are going to be on the limbs that you need to clean off while it's hot. This one actually looks really good. Might be a spot or two, but that's it. Always go back and polish off the lens, always polish it back after you get off the mold. If I get it hot, then I'll throw hot in the forms. And we're going to let it cool off, and we're going to pop it off in the mold, and we're going to start our little putty game here. I'll swap it back a couple of times, and we should be good. Thank you. finishing up here, I would like to reach out and just say thank you to everybody that has supported us, me and my wife. We really appreciate it. This is all that I do. And so if you'd like to show us some support, please head over and check out our website. I will post a link in the description. I really do appreciate all the support from you guys. Every like, every comment, every share, it really does go a long way. It helps us get seen, it helps us get out there. It truly is my passion to create, and I love inspiring, and I love being inspired by other artists. And it really is a great community, and I really do love all you guys. I can't thank you guys enough for showing us the support that you have. So I'm gonna go ahead and let this cool. Not to worry, I'm going to turn around and let you guys take a look at it. I have to do one more punchy exchange here and I think we'll be good. If everything goes well. If you had a really good seal on the other end, you shouldn't really have to pull anything off or clean it off anymore. And we're just going to double check the roundness. And I'll polish it back off and we'll be good to go, guys. Get it hot enough to get rid of anything, but not hot enough to distort it. So now I'm just going to pop it off my little portable marble mold here. And then I will stop the camera, turn it around, and let you guys take a gander. Well, I got to polish off the bottom of this. Down. Okay guys, here is the result of my awesome flower marble. If this video helped you make a cool marble, please just hit that subscribe button and hit the like. If you have any questions or comments, feel free just to leave them down in the comments section below. I will try to get back to you. And I will try to put a video of this one up on the end of this clip here, so that way you guys can see it after it's finished. Okay guys, here is my finished flower marble. It is 1.57 inches and it turned out really nice. I really do appreciate everyone for sticking around for the tutorial. Just gonna enjoy the view for a minute. All right, guys. Thank you all so much.